Hey guys, and welcome back to another test server review. It's stupendous. So here you see we're looking at the Bushi skin. I have no idea how to say that, but this one's kind of like a samurai-esque kind of thing. Really cool face there on the front. This one is probably my favorite skin, the Hoplite skin. I really like the colors and contrast that it gives. I just think this one kind of looks the coolest out of the three that are here. This one has some really cool just features and stuff. Like, it's got those wings even down like on its calf and stuff, so cool details. Just not my favorite one out of the group. So you can see here, yeah, only three of them, and 1,000 gold is probably not what they're going to cost, so don't get up in arms about that. It'll probably change, and they changed it to paint job instead of paintworks, so that happened. And then here you see we're taking a look at some of the things that you can do with the squad system. I really appreciate these changes. They added them in or back in since before, and they made a couple changes as well. So they changed the order on the left side so that your clans, friends, and battle history are kind of in what I would say the best prioritization of them, because you're probably gonna try to get your clan members first and then your friends, and then you'll look to your battle history to find people. So you can check people's profiles like I was doing like right at the beginning. While you're in here, which is really nice, and it'll stop you before you try to start a battle if people haven't accepted their invitations. Chat is available here, and it also shows you who has been or who's going in the game. So here we're featuring the Hoplite skin. I've sped all these up 2 times for you so that you don't have to deal with the slowness, because we're not really featuring battle or strategy too much or anything like that. So I just wanted to include some gameplay of these skins so that you can see them work. And I made sure to throw in a patent with the AC mullets, because you're almost guaranteed to run into about like 40 Furies every single match. So this one's my Fury Spray. Doesn't work super well if you've got Fury Trebs, obviously. Like, I got nailed right at the beginning of using this one, but it makes for a good test server spray anyways. Let's go ahead and take a look here at the next skin. So this one's pretty cool. This is my second favorite out of the three. So that first one that I showed you, the Hoplite skin, that one's my favorite. This one's definitely next in line there for me. I like the orange and blue. I like the details that are on it and stuff. So you guys will have to let me know what you think. What skin do you guys like the most out of the bunch? Is there one in particular that stands out to you? Do you think they should add more? If you would add one, what would it look like? Anything like that, let me know what you guys think. So I left this clip in here for longer because this features the aphids pretty well. I only got to play like 4 or 5 rounds before I ran out of time. I've had a very busy weekend with some church stuff this weekend, so even my Saturday was totally filled up with it. So I wasn't able to play too many rounds, but this is a pretty good round with the aphids. I was able to do quite a bit of damage, and what I thought was funny is nobody else, and I was watching the Center Beacon's channel too. If you guys haven't checked him out, I'll leave a link in the description below, but that's another War Robots channel with commentary, and he does a great job. But he was kind of venting as well, that nobody's like running the patents, and you know, notably there's not tons to run this test server, but it'd be kind of nice to see more people running them kind of thing, so that you know, I could see what they look like, you know, coming up against them kind of thing, because right now I'm only seeing, you know, the 6 o'clock view of of these guys. So these griffins are back for their canyon debut, and I was just checking them there to see if they had clip, and I wasn't sure if they did or not. I wasn't sure if I was getting hit by bolt spread or not, so I'm just seeing what I can do with them. I found out that you can push them around and stuff, and it doesn't look like they have clip, but I do go back and test it again when there's some guys with trebs instead of something with bolt spread later on in the video. So here's that Hoplite skin again. This one's my favorite, and I added this entire round in because this was probably the funnest round that I played, and I wanted you guys to have some good gameplay to watch, just for some like strategy and stuff like that if you wanted to pick it up. I'll point out a couple things in here that I do. We've got this patent outfitted with the AC mullets again, and then like I said before, this is my Fury Spray for when I'm on the test server, because then you can stay outside of the Trident and Zeus range, but you are still going to run into guys running sniper versions of it, so this isn't the perfect fix for it. But you see this guy with Zeus, he's unable to do anything to me. And we were able to take his health down pretty well here. So I'm standing over here with this like trash can thing that I'm kind of working around right there. you can use that as cover. I don't know if you guys have done that or tried that, but the Patton is actually the perfect bot to use it because its guns go around the side of it perfectly, and then the top guns go right over the top of it, so it's a really good choice to use. Another perk to using firearms, even in like level, you know, level 12, like high gold gameplay and stuff, is that they can be pretty helpful against Lancelots because of their bullet spread. So you see the guy with Trebs over there, he keeps shooting this little thing that I'm standing next to using his cover. And he's not able to hit me. I think he hit me with one of those, but I'm just keeping that cover between me and him. So just as a little something for this map, keep that in mind. You can use that little cover feature like that. I used it the other day with a Griffin, and I was able to mitigate a lot of damage, even though the Griffin is Gigantor. So anyway, so here's that kind of samurai skin again. I'm just rolling with the aphids. So as far as using the aphids goes, this map, you end up getting stuck out in the open quite a bit. They can still be used pretty effectively, especially when you get these big bots around. The Lancelot's a good target for it because you can get a good amount of damage in with it. So I was trying to get over there just to see if we could change the beacon at least to neutral before I got taken out, but we weren't able to. So we gave it our best effort though. So I'm just trying to stay away from those two furies over there with Trebs. but yeah, the funniest part probably about the four or five rounds that I played is that I was the top scorer or the second best scorer in every round that I played in, which is really funny because everyone else is running like five Lancelots or like four Lancelots and a fury or like three furies or something like that. And if they're playing those right, they should be doing much more damage than that, especially with level 12 weapons. So you see me here pushing these guys around, trying to see if they have clip. I was going to see if I could advance on those snipers enough. This guy ended up moving up on my left, but I was going to see if I could move up on them enough with one of those to take them out. But yeah, they definitely don't have clip, meaning they don't have a hitbox. So I was hoping that we could do something with that. But yeah, I thought it would be funny if we could make it all the way over to the snipers and then take them out with our aphids. But yeah, the Patton Pinatas is even in gold tier, it can be a pretty good combo. There's other combos that are better, but if you happen to have like maxed one or something like that, and you have maxed pinatas, you can do 88,000 damage per salvo with it, which is pretty significant damage. That's nearly half of a Lancelot's health. The thing you need to keep in mind is that when you're rolling with it, you need to make sure that you are staying with that 300 meter range that the pinatas have. Running other bots, like a lot of times you get in closer and stuff like that, but in general, because you have 15 seconds before you can do anything and you don't have a high health pool, you want to make sure that you're kind of using that max range to your advantage. So you see me moving up on him so I can get into that max range and then using the cover available to kind of skip behind. And so we're able to support pretty well with it. yeah, so this hoplite skin, like I said, this is my favorite one, so that's why I stuck two of them into my hanger. But anyways, you can see here with that squad system, you got those ones next to those guys' names. Those are there indicating that those guys are squatting together, if some of you guys were wondering. Something else that's cool with squad is you can transfer ownership and stuff. So here I'm just showing that these guys, like, I did very well in the match with a bunch of Pattons, and these guys are running that kind of stuff. And sometimes you run into friends when you're on the test server. So this is Mini K from Gods. He's the clan leader from the Gods of War Robots. So we were just kind of staring at each other there, having fun, because we're like, oh, I found you! How exciting! It was just kind of funny. I wasn't expecting it at all. So anyways, so you see me using my Fury Spray here, able to help out quite a bit with that. And then we're just kind of chipping into that Lancelot where we can. And so I skipped ahead here to where we're hitting that Lancelot again as he's trying to go over to our side beacon. I couldn't move forward anymore because of a Fury with Trebs that was over at the far side beacon, so far to my left. And I was hoping to take this guy out before he got over that cover, but wasn't able to do too much. And I think Mini K from Gods is supporting me over here. So that's another channel. If you guys haven't checked it out, do make sure that you check it out. I'll also have a link in the description below for that, for his channel. His channel is doing super well. I mean, a lot of you guys, if you're watching my channel, you've probably watched his. And he doesn't have voice commentary, but he does really good edits for his videos. And then he also has like comments that he puts in there that you guys can read. And a lot of people like that, especially if you don't speak English very well and can't understand me very well. A channel like that would be great because then you can pause it and read the English, which is often much easier than trying to interpret somebody who speaks American English because we don't speak English very well. So, and here I'm just kind of showcasing server lag and stuff. That was something I ran into a lot on this test server. There's a couple other bugs and stuff, but the server lag was the biggest thing. There's tons of delayed damage. Like that guy, like it looks like he was spraying around, but he actually wasn't. If you watch my health bar on this, and then if you back up and watch me with the Griffin, it was pretty bad. But anyways, thanks so much for coming and checking out the video, guys. If you like this, smash the thumbs up button, and we'll see you in the next one.